Hey, it's Scott Disick.
Even if you know him best as Kourtney Kardashian's ex-man and baby daddy, Scott Disick has become an honorary member of the mega-famous family over the years, despite the breakup. Scott has become a celebrity in his own right after starring on Keeping Up with the Kardashians for years while he was in a relationship with Kourtney. He remains super close with the family and is still part of the show and the goings-on. However, he has his own ventures these days as well. Scott is 36 years old at the time of this recording, and although the man doesn't have his own Wikipedia page anymore, he's become one of the more interesting characters on reality TV and will probably just continue to be relevant. Scott has 23 million followers on Instagram at the time of this recording, and he was most famous for being with Kourtney, who he had 3 children with. Since 2017, Scott has been in a relationship with the much younger Sofia Richie, who's like 15 years younger than him. The two do seem happy, and she's close to the Kardashian-Jenners too, but I'm not surprised with that family. Scott even said about his relationship with Sofia, "It's hard anywhere to find someone you feel comfortable with. The truth was, without her, I was always looking for somebody or something. She's definitely been that little piece that's calmed me down and made me a better man, and made things, you know, easier in my life." Post-breakup from Kourtney, Scott obviously moved out of the home in the Oaks he shared with her, and had to get a new mansion in Hidden Hills. He renovated the place, which we know Scott loves to do, considering he began his own reality show earlier this year called Flip It Like Disick, where he flips high-end homes.
It's been pretty good.
It seems the guy is doing pretty well for himself with a net worth rumored at 20 million, and you can see it all from his fancy house, cars, and more that he loves to show off. Today we're going to be focusing on the mansion where Scott currently calls home and the details of his place, here for you on Famous Entertainment. Hey guys, it's Kara, and today we're doing another house tour. We're going to look at Scott Disick's bachelor pad he completely flipped and where he's currently living, his previous place where Kourtney lives now, and more. If you like these videos, make sure you're subscribed and ring that bell to be notified when we post so you can always be up to date. We've also done house tours on the Kardashian-Jenner clan, including his baby mama Kourtney, and we'll have links to those at the end of this. Be sure to follow me on Instagram because I love connecting with you guys. I've also been reading all your comments and I'm going to be responding to some at the end of this. I need you to let me know who to do next in the comments down below and whose home you'd like to see. Now let's get into this video. First of all, let's look at Scott's old real estate while he was still with Kourtney. We know the two had a few epic homes together and they redesigned those ones too. The earlier house that Scott shared with Kourtney was located in Calabasas, California, like the rest, but it was a bit smaller than what he's upgraded to since. This place was purchased back in 2010 for $1.7 million, which doesn't seem like a high asking price for the location. It was 5,400 square feet and had 4 beds and 4.5 baths. Apparently, the home wasn't big enough for Scott and Kourtney's growing family, so they eventually decided to get a bigger place. Designer Jeff Andrews helped to completely reimagine this home and definitely made it unique. Maybe all of the work Scott and Kourtney had done to their homes inspired Scott's idea for flipping houses. Back then, Scott actually described this home as Alice in Wonderland meets Beetlejuice, which I can totally see. The new design included bright colored furniture and statement pieces inside black and white rooms. Scott's office definitely had those vibes. Even the books on the shelves were color coordinated. When Scott and Kourtney upgraded to a new mansion, it was in the area of the Oaks, which is also in Calabasas, just beside Hidden Hills. This place might look a little familiar because Kourtney is actually still living here. Scott and Kourtney got this place back in 2014 for $8.5 million. The mansion spans 12,000 square feet with 6 beds and 9 bathrooms, so you could say that they got their wish of having a bigger family home. This place has an expansive yard and pool with gorgeous views, but most of the homes in these neighborhoods do have great views of the hills. Even though the house looked fancy enough when Scott and Kourtney purchased it, they flipped this place too. Unfortunately, I don't think Scott would have been able to enjoy this home much after the redesign, since the couple would be calling it quits soon. Now with Scott out of the picture, Kourtney has all that space for her and the kiddies. Don't be fooled though, Scott's home gives this place a run for its money, and you'll see what I mean now. When Scott and Kourtney ended their relationship for good, of course the man needed a place to live. And if you know Scott, you know he enjoys the finer things. He wasn't about to move into a lame bachelor pad, that's for sure. And why should he? Scott had an extra house on hand that was an investment property, so apparently that was his full-time spot for a while post-split. This place was in the Beverly Park area of Beverly Hills, and it was built back in 1960. It was 4,000 square feet, and there were 5 beds, 6 baths, and gorgeous views of the canyon, ocean, and city. Moving outside, there was a saltwater pool and spa, a garden with a water fountain, and even views of Catalina Island from the backyard. But this wasn't enough for Scott to settle into. He ended up purchasing a home in Hidden Hills, close to the Kardashian-Jenners, right in their fave neighborhood. Scott paid just under $6 million for the home back in January 2016 and started to flip the place pretty quickly. Scott certainly hasn't been shy about showing off his place, that's for sure.
How you doing? I'm Scott Disick, and welcome to my house.
His Hidden Hills home is described as partly farmhouse style and inspired by the East Coast, the Hamptons to be exact. Scott is a native New Yorker himself, so it makes sense that he would want that Hamptons feel. The place looks pretty minimalistic and doesn't have much color at all. It's a lot of white interior and wooden flooring. Comparing photos of the house pre-reno and now, you can see just how much Scott has really done to the place. Scott's home is just over 8,000 square feet of living space with 7 beds and 6.5 baths. It was built back in 1968 and is located on a private road. The master suite in this house has custom closets, a private balcony, fireplace, and more. Scott has his own personal seating area here, and other add-ons for his room were pretty epic too. Scott has a massive custom 9x8 foot bed, and the room has a total hotel feel. He also has a projection screen that comes down from the ceiling, which acts as a wall to make the room cozier, and as a personal movie theater from bed. Of course, Scott also redesigned the master bathroom to his liking, and I think he made it much nicer. The whole home on the main floor is really modern looking and open concept. There's a redone kitchen, dining space, multiple living areas, and a large wine cellar tucked underneath the stairs. If you don't feel like watching movies in bed, there's another main movie theater located on the main floor. I definitely like Scott's idea of a big U-shaped couch instead of movie theater seats though, because it seems way more comfy and practical. 3 of the bedrooms are on the main floor, and one even has sliding glass doors leading you right to the pool. Moving outside of Scott's home, he called the original kidney-shaped pool absolutely horrible and replaced it with an infinity pool. Scott did a ton of work to the outdoor area of this home and really wanted to show off the impressive views from the property. He clearly also likes to show off his multiple luxury cars, and he has plenty of space for all of them at his mansion, or what he likes to call his motor court. Despite all of the efforts Scott put into making this mansion a home, it's apparently been listed on the market, and he's tried to both rent it and sell it in the past. A while back, Scott was trying to rent the home for $60,000 a month, but I don't think he had any success. As far as I know, he's still living in his Hidden Hills mansion, and it seems like Sophia and their dog, Hershella, are happily living there too at the time. So now we've seen Scott's old homes he shared with Kourtney and his current home in Hidden Hills that he flipped and is obviously really proud of. What do you guys think of Scott's mansion? Is he a good house flipper or nah? There are rumors that Scott and Sophia are looking for a new place though. The couple was shown looking for houses in Malibu on an episode of Flip It Like Disick. Apparently, the two even looked at a massive house worth over 19 mil that was 22,000 square feet. Either way, Sophia wants to put her own touches on a home they start together and said Scott's place was like a bachelor pad. I guess we'll just have to see what's next for Scott and if he ends up selling his masterpiece of a mansion in Hidden Hills. Okay guys, now it's time for me to read out some comments from past videos. Sonia Phillips commented on our Will Smith house tour saying, "Beautiful." And Mia Mariner commented on the same video saying, "They have 3 kids." Well, Sonia, I'm glad you like their house. I feel like a lot of you did from the comments. And Will does have 3 kids, which I mentioned in the video, but his oldest son Trey is from his marriage before Jada, so as a couple, they only have 2. And finally, Cassie42 commented on our Khloe Kardashian house tour saying, "All of that house for 2 people is stupid." I can't say I disagree since it's only Khloe and her daughter there, but I think it's normal for this family to have houses that are a little bit extra. Alright guys, that's all I could find on Scott's mansion. What do you guys think about his place in the Hidden Hills? And what was your favorite part of the house? I really like the master bedroom with the projection screen. If I had a mansion, I would definitely need a movie theater sized TV for my bed. Let me know in the comments and let me know some other celebrity houses you'd like to see. Follow me on Instagram if you want to chat more, and I'll see you next time with some more videos. Bye!